out here at Tybee Island, beach day with the family. Second time we've taken it out, seems to be doing pretty well. Holding up to the winds. Wind's been kicking, as you can see behind us. We got some storms rolling in. About to pack up. Been out here for a few hours. Had to do a couple of adjustments, but as soon as you get it down, set up properly, it sets up pretty nice. Holds up well. We got 2 adults, 3 kids, plenty of space. I think this is just the Neso Grande, and they have one more size above this one. I know that they stay, or they state to put the poles about 1 foot in, but you're really just gonna figure it out as you go what's gonna be the best tightness. So it's a good rule of thumb for about 1 foot inside from the corners, but we have the regular Grande poles that come with it on the back. Ordered 2 more of the shorter poles so I could try to angle it, maybe get a little bit more shade depending on where the sun is, sun positioning. The wind is blowing out towards the water, so that's why we have it angled that way. First time was actually perfect. The wind was blowing in towards the tent. Worked out really well, but still, even with the shorter poles in the front, seems to work out. Still got plenty of line of sight out to the beach. So if that's something you're interested in, you can get those 2 extra poles separate. But as you can see, this is our 2nd go around with it. Held up really well. Winds, I wish I knew how fast the winds were today. They were significant. There was another tent over there. They're packing it up. It was a Sun something. It wasn't the Sun Ninja, but it was another one. Theirs held up pretty well too. And then there was a Sun Sail here. They were struggling with theirs. The wind kept changing and blowing pretty hard. They had to keep on readjusting theirs. But overall, if you're interested in one of these, I'd say it is well worth the money.